speed.
Sailors, two dogs, and a
snake. So the first plan, you still have the double sweep, right? No. This isn't 100% necessary. They're going to catch you to be this far hard to this hand. Okay. So I can actually be close and hold my own lapel here. You know, I keep playing this game. Okay. Head there. Grab it. Feet in the back hand. And the front of the leg. Grab his collar. Same thing, hands on the beast. Put my foot on his leg. Pull his shoulders in back. Block, I'm not necessarily pushing. Just blocking. So he can't do it. Same thing, you can step around arm bar. You can smash pass. It takes that control. Okay? Very, very similar to the first one we did on the easy. Now we're starting to do stuff with the near side arm. Okay. So either I'm going here, yep, and grab that. So either I switch my grip and I can grab it with my arms around, or I get control of it from here. Okay. And we're having two sweeps, but they're basically the same sweep with different grips. Okay. First sweep, I have this closest arm, and I push it through. Holding, I'm going to figure four, but remember, it's going to come harder. Okay. Then from here, I'm rotating underneath. I'm diving my head underneath. That's going to put his weight on me. I want his weight to land on me or over me. Okay. From here, I'm rotating. Dive my head. I push my shin. I can keep rotating. Over here. A little bit over. Switch my top knee. Now I can bail. I can bail on this right here. Pull the sweep. Okay. One thing that you can do, you can switch from here. You know, if you don't like, you know, if he's like pulling that away or something, you can switch to his ankle. Okay. Once you get this grip here, straighten your arm. Don't keep your arm bent. You know, it's a losing battle. So if you lock your arm straight, it's going to be really hard for him to move his hip. You can't move around. It's really hard for him to move. Meanwhile, keep this knee up high. Flip on your other knee and drive straight across to the leg right position. That's it. So, that was the second sweep. Third sweep. From here. But instead of grabbing with this outside hand in figure four, we're going to just feed it to our hand, a hooking hand. Okay. So either you can reach around, grab this, pull it, or you're looking for this one and he's breaking your grip and you just grab it with your other hand. Okay. So from here, everything is the same. I'm still going to rotate underneath, but this hand is going to come underneath his leg, his far leg. As I rotate underneath, come under his far leg. Same thing here if you want. You can go on the leg, right? But you're going to be a grip. But it might be easier once you climb up to here to hug and control the legs. Come under here. Come under your own back end. So now he's pretty stuck here. You can move around and then I can control his hips away. So those two suits are essentially the same thing. Okay. And the last sweep, that's it. Here, hold on. Well, he's not gonna have a hard time grabbing anything. He decides to drive right into you. So I just put underneath him when I make him face. Okay. Lift him, scoop his knee, or I'm sorry, scoop his ankle, and turn. Okay, right. And finish the sweep. Here, he decides to try it into him, so I bump my hips underneath, and that makes him go up. Then he uses to lift, but if he's already like super high like this, super resistant. I can't turn or force that weight.
You have his legs.
Bunch him up and pounce.
And you can come here and smash, come back this way.
Windshield wiper.
From the front. Any questions on those? That's a quick review of this last week. Well, we're going to finish drilling. We'll finish the class just drilling.
I have one question on the single hand grip.
Yeah.
This, I think, was the second step in this. Okay. When I get to that position, like my hands too deep, I kind of end up in this wrist lock L type position.
This one right here?
Yeah. Does that matter?
So when you do the full sweep?
So this one?
Yep. All the way over. And you end up there and then like bite that hand, like the hold super tight.
Oh, yeah.
Like I find my fingers get stuck and then my wrist just gets kind of jammed up there.
Your fingers get stuck and you can't let go?
I can't let go. It'll get jammed up pretty easily.
Yeah, I don't know if I have like a good answer for that besides just like maybe holding and freeing your grip. I don't have, ideally you want to keep control of it, but if they're really like, wrenching on it and your fingers are stuck, that's a tough one. Like, this is a more secure grip. Like, you can, if you want to try it with a pistol grip, that's fine. But it's just not as secure as a hook grip. So,
so you're also just like in that super deep and get that hand behind the knee? Or is that? Let's get kind of stuck there.
So you're talking about not a super deep grip here?
Yeah, like if I end up there and I try and go for the sweep, I just kind of end up getting stuck and my wrist just kind of goes like this shit.
Yeah.
One thing you can just let go. So,
as soon as you go.
Yeah, once you're here, you rotate under. Let go of that.
Go into like a snap pass or something. So, yeah.
There's appropriate times to let go of things once he's, past the point of no return.
It's okay. So, yeah. But ideally, you want to keep things like super tight the whole way through if you can. But there are techniques where you want to just kind of. They go one way and once another down, just bail. Just like the heck that deep half sweep when you're sweeping backwards.
Right.
Well, let go of your legs and just let go. Like that. Any other questions? At least standing. Should guard teams. Okay. Let's break off. Do those. Two sets of three. And that will be it for class. I just kind of want to do a recap of the last week. We're pretty familiar with the seated stuff, the dump sweep, the butterfly sweep, the knee tap, all that stuff, and then the deep half sweep, so a little under. So we're pretty familiar with those. Let's do standing. Okay. Partner up, let's get another 1, 2, 3.